Infrastructure development can do great things. Open and connect new markets and populations, enhance economies, provide access to medical care and clean water, provide jobs and revenue, and produce electricity. It can also do bad things. Poison water sources, reduce air quality and increase greenhouse gas emissions, accelerate forest and wildlife loss, promote illegal logging and wildlife smuggling, generate landslides and wildfires, displace people leading to forced migration, destroy cultures and social networks, and incur enormous debt burdens. How infrastructure development is planned and implemented can make the difference between helping and harming economies, communities, and their supporting natural environments. The world is currently investing around $2.7 trillion a year in infrastructure, such as new and upgraded power plants, railways, highways, dams, mines, and telecommunications infrastructure. But the need is estimated at $3.7 trillion. And so, investors are ramping up spending. China has taken a leading role through its ambitious Belt and Road Initiative. Japan, Korea, the World Bank, and many other countries and international financial institutions are increasing their investments as well. How countries plan their infrastructure projects and work with investors and construction firms will determine whether these countries realize great results, great failures, or something in between. Ultimately, it is the countries hosting new infrastructure that are in the best position to make sure that the infrastructure provides the services and benefits that the country needs. Hello, everyone. I'm Lydia Olander from Duke University. I am working with a team of experts at Duke and partner institutions to build an online training curriculum for countries that are building new infrastructure. This training will help these countries to plan and implement projects that are economically, environmentally, and socially sustainable, and create a peer-to-peer network for shared learning. We are designing this online course to enhance the knowledge and capacity of governments, development professionals, and civil society organizations within countries hosting new infrastructure projects to best address their country's needs. In this course, you will learn about the importance of sustainable development, the role that financing countries and financial institutions play in decision-making, the economic, environmental, and social risks of infrastructure development, the tools, methods, and approaches that can help manage these risks, the opportunities and leverage points in the development process for improving infrastructure outcomes, the role of host country laws, regulations, and enforcement, opportunities in contract negotiation, and approaches to assess and monitor impacts of infrastructure development. The course will include exercises that explore how all of this is relevant to a real-world infrastructure project. So, what will this course look like? It will be presented through engaging videos by global experts and local practitioners and supported with readings and exercises. It will be offered on a common online platform. Country-specific, customized versions with in-country details will be developed where there is demand. The course will initially be available in English, with subtitles and transcripts available in local languages. Participants will have the opportunity to join a learning network that includes the instructors and other participants from around the world to share ideas and lessons learned. What's next? We are in the planning and development stage for this online course and related capacity building efforts. We would greatly appreciate your feedback and input regarding what you would like to see in this type of training and online course, and how to make it accessible and useful to you. Please take a few minutes and respond to our survey. With your help, we hope to build a network of engaged experts working together to build better infrastructure.